बेबी कार्तिका। गिव अ नोट ऑन पेपर क्रोमेटोग्राफी।
पेपर क्रोमेटोग्राफी इज अ प्लेनर
योर
क्रोमेटोग्राफी।
वॉइस इज नॉट ऑडिबल, बी लाउडर।
मैम इट इज यूज्ड इन क्वालिटेटिव एनालिसिस। इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय मार्टिन एंड सिंच। इट वर्किंग टुगेदर ऑन प्रोटीन्स विथ मेड ऑफ चेन्स ऑफ अमीनो एसिड्स। Acids are soluble in nature.
Okay. Anybody else define the paper chromatography? What are the chromatographic parameters we have discussed? Vimal. Vimal. Stephen. Any one of you can explain the
Yes, ma'am.
chromatographic parameters?
Hello, ma'am.
Stephen.
Chromatography. Partition chromatography. Liquid-liquid chromatography. Planar chromatography, ascending development technique, and one dimensional development technique, ma'am. These are all the principles of chromatographic parameters, ma'am.
Okay. What other parameters we have discussed? Just name the parameters.
Stationary phase. Hello, ma'am. Hello. Hello.
Same.
Ma'am, stationary phase, mobile phase. Then sample application, application of the chromatography.
Okay.
And positioning of the stationary phase, ma'am.
Okay.
And development time. That's it.
Okay, pa. Thank you. Anybody else? Can anyone recollect chromatographic parameters again, what we have discussed?
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Paper chromatography, it comes under the panel chromatography, ma'am. It's meant for quality analysis, ma'am. Martin and Singh, paper chromatography was invented by two British biochemists, ma'am. They separated a protein which is made up of chain of amino acids.
Okay.
Chromatography parameter, principal partition chromatography, liquid-liquid chromatography, planar chromatography, ascending development technique, one-dimensional development technique by capillary action, ma'am. Chromatography parameters, stationary phase, material, Wattman filter paper, number one grade, ma'am.
Okay.
Paper is made with cellulose fiber, incorporated with molecules through hydrogen binding, and that water molecules act as stationary phase.
Very good. Okay. Regarding mobile phase, what composition will be preferring for paper chromatography?
N-butanol composition. N-butanol glacial acetic acid. It is organic phase, ma'am, and water
so
is
what, organic phase and aqueous phase.
Mobile phase chamber 250 ml glass beaker with the petri dish lid.
Okay. What is the ideal development time and saturation time?
Ideal development saturation time 20 minutes, ma'am.
Not the development time, it is chamber saturation time, that is 20 minutes. Development time will be varying according to the mobile phase movement and other factors like environmental factors.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Pa, good. Good. We'll move on to the class now.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Shakti Vel, Baby Kartika, and Steffi. Now let's move on to the remaining part of paper chromatography. So we have seen history of paper chromatography, then under chromatographic parameters, principle, stationary phase selection, and under stationary phase, material composition of stationary phase, dimension of stationary phase, everything we have discussed. And under mobile phase composition, mobile phase chamber, chamber saturation, ideal chamber saturation time was discussed. And under sample application, about the concentration and application of sample on the stationary phase was discussed. And about location of stationary phase inside the chamber also were discussed. And regarding development time and drying, means drying under each step we have discussed. Now let's move on to the deduction. Once your sample has been developed over the paper like this, in the beginning itself you won't observe color. If you are not observing color visibly, then we need to convert your sample or locate your sample by means of using some reagents or some radiation. Okay, then only we can find the location of sample over the stationary phase. So always you will not spot colored sample. You will be spotting colorless samples only. So they would have developed in the paper up to 3/4 movement of your mobile phase, that is called as solvent front. This is solvent front. This is solvent and the paper where it has moved 3/4 distance. Okay, so it should be the spot developed maybe or may not be colorless or colored. Okay, so we need to locate or identify the located spot or separated spot over the stationary phase. How we can detect this spots present? Then only we can identify what sample is separated by comparing with standard samples. Okay. For that, the next step is deduction of spot. Deduction procedures we need to discuss. So what are the different deduction methods are available to detect a spot that is separated in the plate, that is stationary phase. There are two different types of methods. One is destructive method, another one is non-destructive method. Here I have not given in the notes. I'll give you in the from textbooks or in the next class. While discussing under TLC, I'll give you the material for deduction. Now I'll explain orally. Okay, so deduction of chromatographic paper chromatograph or paper chromatographic spots, we can use two methods. So what are the two methods? Destructive method and non-destructive method. Where destructive methods will destruct the sample. That means when you pass some reagents, chemical reagents, your separated spots will be interacting with your chemical reagent and forms a colored compound, so that we can find through color formation, we can find what sample it is. So specific detecting reagents or visualizing reagents we will be using. So using detecting reagent or visualizing reagent. Visualizing means color spot appearing, means formation of colored compound that can be visualized. So that reagent is called visualizing reagent or detecting reagent. We are detecting the sample that has been separated over the paper. So this type of reagents, when it is used, then this comes under destructive method. What type of method it is? Destructive method. Why it is called destructive method? Since the sample is interacting with your reagent, visualizing reagent, then it gives colored compound. Your sample was colorless. You don't know where your sample has been separated and located over the stationary phase paper. So you are spraying or through some methods, spraying or dipping. There are different methods for applying directing reagent over the paper, either spraying method or by means of dipping method, will be applying directing reagent over the paper. Then that reagent has the chemical, that is the visualizing reagent chemical, that will be interacting with your separated spot, where your sample, the spot has your sample. That is of not visible one. When it is reacting with colored compound, it will be giving color. That color should be visualized, and from that we can identify where the sample has been separated and located over the paper when it was developed. Okay. So this type of method is called destructive method, where if you don't want to disturb your sample, if you want to recover your separated sample from the paper, then we need to go with detecting method of non-destructive method. It should not destroy your separated sample. So we need to choose non-destructive method. It is another category of detection procedure where we can pass UV radiation at two wavelengths for detection. Most of the compounds will show color or fluorescence, or it will absorb and give fluorescence, mostly organic molecules, at shorter wavelength and longer wavelength. Okay, so that type of detection is called as UV chamber analysis or fluorescence detection method. Okay, by means of fluorescence detection or using UV chamber, we can call that method as, when you are going for detection, then method is called as non-destructive method, where your sample will not get destroyed or disturbed. Okay, so you can recover the sample from stationary phase for further use. You can go for characterization likewise with the that type of detection method is called fluorescence reduction by using UV chamber as a instrument. Okay, I told two wavelengths. What are the two wavelengths are used for emitting fluorescence of the separated spot? Spot will be glowing with the fluorescence when you keep it or pass keep it under UV light. Of two wavelengths we can use, either shorter wavelength or longer wavelength. Shorter wavelength means UV light will be measured with wavelength. So only it is mentioned as wavelength. Light measuring parameter is wavelength there. So what is shorter wavelength? That is 254 nanometer. Longer wavelength is 365 nanometer. So at this two wavelengths, your sample either if your sample may emit at two wavelengths, or it may emit your fluorescence at any one wavelength. So you can check your spot by means of using any two wavelengths. One is shorter and another one is longer wavelength. So by means of passing that wavelength radiation to your paper, which is having separated spot, it will be emitting fluorescence after absorbing the UV light. But your sample will not destroy it by means of that absorption. So you can detect the sample thereby, and you can calculate RF value, and you can detect what sample it is without destroying the sample. Okay, so these are the two detection methods available for detection of separated samples in the paper chromatography. What are the two methods? Destructive method and non-destructive method. Where destructive method comprising detecting reagent method or visualizing reagent method, and non-destructing method is fluorescence detection. That is using UV chamber, where it has two wavelengths of light. What are the two wavelengths? Shorter and longer. Shorter is 254 nanometer, longer is 365 nanometer. Okay, so after spraying or after detecting your sample, then you need to dry. If you are going with the reagent method, then you have to dry your paper again at 60 degrees Celsius for 5 to 10 minutes in hot air oven to detect the colored spot. Okay, some coloring reagents will give color immediately when you spray with spray over the paper. If some reagents, if you heat only, it will emit the color. So at what temperature we need to heat for getting color? Only at 60 degrees Celsius. If you heat more than that, your sample by means of heat itself, it will be destroyed. So that only this temperature should be noted, that is at 60 degrees Celsius. And how much time you need to heat? 5 to 10 minutes in hot air oven, it should be heated for getting color. Okay, once the color is produced, then you can mark the spot and you can go for further process. Okay, in case if you are going with amino acid deduction, then what deducting reagent you are using? Ninhydrin reagent. It is what ratio will be using, 1:20 volume by volume with distilled water or acetone. We can use either polar or non-polar solvent according to our convenience for preparation of ninhydrin reagent, or already ready-made reagent also available that you can use directly. If you go with that reagent, then what is the drying temperature of paper to get color? At 60 degrees Celsius, we need to heat the paper under hot air oven for 5 to 10 minutes. So it will give Roman's purple color. What color it will give? Roman's purple color. Then after getting colored spot like this, you can observe this picture. You have to mark with pencil for your location of spots. It will be appearing with over oval shaped spot you will be getting. So you need to mark circle or oval shape you will be getting. So you have to mark the whole spot and go for deduction of RF value. What is RF means? It is retardation factor. This is the parameter by using which we can detect the sample, what sample you have separated. So RF in chromatographic analysis, it stands as qualitative respect. Okay, qualitative respect means it is applicable for qualitative analysis of samples. Qualitative means what? For deduction or identification of samples. So what for this purpose, what parameter we are using in chromatography? RF. F should be in subscript. Okay, subscript. This is the common parameter for any chromatographic analysis we are using as qualitative respect. Mainly planar chromatographic analysis. Planar. What are the planar techniques? Paper TLC and HPTLC. For these three techniques, qualitative respect will be RF. What is RF? It is distance from origin run by the compound. What is origin? Where is origin? That is the baseline where you have spotted your sample. It is above, baseline should be marked above the mobile phase. This is mobile phase solvent, and above which you have marked the baseline. Over on baseline, you have spotted your sample, right? So that is the origin for sample movement. So distance from origin run by the compound. How much distance along with the mobile phase your compound run? Okay, that is the distance of your sample. So you are getting the spots, right? Up to what distance you will be calculating the distance? Whether up to the bottom of the spot or up to the center of the spot? What distance you will be calculating? Up to the center. Okay, from the origin line, mark the distance in centimeter by using scale up to the center of the spot, not at the top bottom or top of the spot. It should be measured up to center of the spot. So from here to the center, you can see the marking. So how much centimeter it shows, you can write that is the distance traveled by the sample along with the solvent, and divided by it is the ratio of distance of solvent and sample. So the distance from origin run by the solvent. So from baseline, how much distance to reach solvent front the solvent has been traveled. So that should be in centimeter, nearly 10 or 8 centimeter, whichever, according to the 3/4 distance where you have allowed and stopped the solvent to move, and that is solvent front. And note down the distance of solvent front. So your sample distance may be of 2 centimeter, your solvent front may be of 10 centimeter. So 2 by 10. So you will get in fractions only RF value. Below 1 you have to get. Ideal RF value should be between 0.1 to 0.9. So below 1 your RF ratio will be. Okay, this is the standard or ideal RF value for any compound. So likewise for second compound and third compound, you can calculate RF value. This is your inference for paper chromatographic analysis. After location of spots over the plate by means of deduction, we are calculating RF value for identifying the sample. And the RF value what you are detecting for the sample will be compared with the standard to know what type of compound it is. For example, we have seen the separation of amino acids, right? So amino acids will be giving Roman purple color spot. not of this colors, purple color spot you will be getting. So if the compound is located here, the first compound you are detected at this place, you have to compare with the standard amino acid. For example, if you are taking cysteine or aspartic acid or whatever, glycine, whatever amino acid if you take, you can compare with the known amino acid, that is glycine. Separate the sample along with the standard. You spot another standard also here, allow it to separate along with your sample. So if it matches like this, if it matches with the spot, you consider this is standard and this is your sample. So both are appearing with same color and same distance. So your sample may be of, if you have it is taken as cysteine or glycine or some amino acid, whatever you decide. So if it matches with the glycine, then your compound is finalized or detected as glycine. So you have to report when comparing with standard, your sample is detected as glycine with the RF value of so and so. You can give your report. Likewise, you will be deciding what class of compound you have separated by comparing with standard. In analytical methods, mostly we'll be coming to conclusion of your sample deduction or analysis will be compared with, by comparing with standard only, we'll be concluding the results. Okay. Now, if you merely, if you separate your sample alone, you cannot identify what sample it is from only knowing sample RF value. Sample RF value must be compared with standard RF value to know what sample it is. So it is the main parameter we will be analyzing in the paper chromatographic method, mainly planar chromatographic method. So in planar chromatography, what is qualitative aspect? RF value. What is RF value? Distance travel by the sample from origin line or baseline, baseline in the paper. Okay, then distance travel by the solvent from the origin line up to solvent front. So it is the ratio of distance from origin run by the compound to the distance from origin run by the solvent. Okay, ideal RF value is 0.1 to 0.9. It should be always below 1. What are RX value and RM value? These are also important, but we'll not use much. It is distance traveled by sample divided by distance traveled by standard. RX value, it is always closer to 1. Mostly sample and standard will be same, will be having same RF value, right? So if you divide, it will be close to 1. Then mobile phase allowed to travel throughout the plate. So mobile phase will not calculate solvent front. It is not dependent on solvent front. You have to, for why we need to go with RX value means, when you have more mixtures of sample, you need to allow more distance. Then solvent front is not considered, where you can consider your sample with standard. Mostly we'll be performing with solvent front analysis only. We'll not go with RX, but this is also a method available to detect the spot. Okay, so distance traveled by sample and standard. Standard distance is calculated for knowing RX value, where mobile phase solvent is allowed to move throughout the plate. We are, since we are not calculating, the separation is not depended on solvent front, then we are allowing mobile phase to travel full of the plate. Then another value is RM value. It is to find whether the compounds are belonging to homologous series, whether they are belong to same category. If amino acid means whether it is belonging to amino acid category or some other class. So it is a combined value. Delta RM, difference between RM equals to log of 1 divided by RF minus 1. By using this calculation, we can get RM value. So these are all the various deduction parameters or qualitative parameters for paper chromatography, among which RF value we are using commonly. What are the three parameters? RF, RX, RM. RF is distance of compound and solvent, where RX is distance of sample and standard. RF, ideal RF value is 0.1 to 0.9, where ideal RX is always closer to 1. Okay, it's not in fractions, it will be closer to 1, and either plus or minus 1 it will be. And then RM value will be of combined value, it tells about which homologous series a compound belongs to. Okay, it is calculated by RF equals to log of 1 divided by RF minus 1. So what are the deduction methods we have discussed? Destructive and non-destructive method. Under destructive method, what is the technique we are using? By using deducting reagent or visualizing reagent, will deduct the spot. Either if a color is not appeared after immediately spraying the reagent, then we need to dry the paper at 60 degrees Celsius for 5 to 10 minutes in hot air oven. What color according to the reagent and sample use, color will be changed. For amino acid, when it is reacting with ninhydrin, it will give romance purple color. Then regarding calculation and calculating or considering what sample or deducting what sample it is, we need to calculate using either RF, RX or RM. Commonly used is RF value, where it is calculated and it is called as qualitative respect. What does RF represent is retardation factor. Retardation factor. R represents retardation, F represents factor. Retardation factor. Why it is called retardation factor means your sample is allowed to move along with the solvent, but solvent is moved up to 3/4 distance, but your sample is retained here. It is due to retarding force given to the sample while moving on to the plate. A retarding physical force called retarding force is retarded your sample to move along with the solvent. And that factor is calculated by means of distance traveled by the solvent and your sample, so that it is called retardation factor. So we are calling it as RF. Okay. And other parameters are RM and RX. Let's move on to the different development techniques on paper chromatography. Mostly we have covered all the parameters from beginning. So first we'll revise once and then we'll move on to the different development technique. So what principle paper chromatography follows? It is a basic qualitative method. And what are the principle it follows? Partition, liquid-liquid, planar, ascending, one-dimensional and capillary action. And stationary phases, Wortmann filter paper of number one grade with alpha cellulose it has. And this is inert material and it is incorporated with water molecules. They are acting as a stationary phase. And then mobile phase is composed of organic phase and aqueous phase for paper chromatography. And chamber saturation is must, and ideal chamber saturation time is 20 minutes, where sample application will be of concentration. You can take as 0.1 to 2% weight by volume solution, and application device will be of either micropipette or capillary tube is used, and spot should be of drop or and microliters, 1 to 5 microliters. Marking everything over the paper should be done with pencil, not with pen. Then positioning of stationary phase, it can be hanged with the by means of thread at the top of the, by using thread at the top of the paper, you can fold and keep it inside the mobile phase chamber. Then development time is how much time the sample has taken to travel and the solvent to travel to reach 3/4 of the distance. That is called development time from baseline, from origin line, how long it takes to reach 3/4 of the distance. And then drying temperature is drying method for after development is air drying. You are not heating anything at hot air oven. After spotting your sample, the drying is under room temperature only or under air. Likewise, after development also it must be dried under air only. Okay. After deduction, while after spraying the deducting reagent, if we are not getting color, then we have to heat at 60 degrees Celsius, not before that. So next is deduction. So after knowing the principle and nature of sample, you have selected which chromatography you are going for separation. You need to only detect what class of compound or what amino acid or what protein or what carbohydrate, then you can go with paper chromatographic analysis that is meant for qualitative analysis. After choosing the chromatographic technique, you are going for selection of stationary phase, mobile phase, then how to apply sample concentration, how much sample you need and how it is applied. After applying, you are keeping in this saturated mobile phase chamber for development. After noting down the development time, you are going for deduction. What are the deduction methods? Destructive method and non-destructive method. According to your sample nature and according to your need for further process, you can either destroy the sample and deduct, or by means of non-destroying or non-destructive method, you can go for the deduction. After deducting the location of spot, then we can go with calculation of RF value, that is the qualitative analytic analytical parameter, qualitative parameter or qualitative respect. Okay, so it is calculated based on distance traveled by the sample and solvent. Then Rx value and Rm value also are there. The common is Rf value, where Rx is distance traveled by the sample and to the standard. Then Rm is, it is close to, it is combined value to know about which class of compound we have detected. Okay. And now let's move on to the deduction techniques. Shall we see this deduction technique in the next class? Deduction and applications will be discussed in the next class. Thank you all for patient listening. Hope everyone is clear about paper chromatography. This is only the concept, very easy. So regarding development techniques, different development and applications of paper chromatography, general and pharmaceutical applications, we'll discuss in the next class on last 3 to 4 class. If any doubt, you can ask. All are there, no?
Yes, ma'am. Clear, ma'am.
Clear, huh? Okay, pa. Thank you. If you want to get more materials, you just refer the textbooks I have posted or in the net regarding paper chromatography, you can search and gather more points. Okay, for exam and for understanding purpose, these are points you require. And it will cover all the subtopics given under your syllabus. In syllabus, it is not given in the order. Topics are not given in the order. I have changed the order also for, according to your convenience. You can learn mostly. If any concept is missing as per your syllabus, you can intimate me. Accordingly, we will proceed. Okay. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. We'll leave the meeting now.
Okay.